Welcome to Ladies in Conversation, Spiritually Speaking. We are delighted that you are here with us this evening. And this evening's topic is going to be on overcoming Satan's tactics of temptation. And actually, this is part two of a part three, overcoming Satan's tactics. Last week we did on deception. This week we're going to do on temptation. And next week we'll do on accusations. Those are the three main tactics that the enemy uses to try to trick, deceive, and stop the hand, stop the plan, stop the will, purposes of God in the lives of God's people. But he's been caught and exposed. So let's talk about temptation. Temptation often follows deception. You know, if you're deceived, then you can fall easily into that sin, which is really sin is missing the mark. Not doing what God is calling us to do according to his standard of righteousness. So the fruit of the forbidden tree, well, first I want to just say, the enemy tells us you won't surely die. He makes that fruit of the forbidden tree look so good. Since Eve accepted Satan's deception, his lie, now the tree that was not supposed to be touched looked good to her. She was tempted, enticed to sin. Looked good. He sounded good. There was nothing wrong with it. You know, you'll just be like God. When you reach, he already was. There was nothing that was held back from them, from the maker, their creator. But now he has the enemy trying to deceive, to allow her to be tempted to fall into sin. Oh, he's a tricky one. Because she allowed herself to first to be what? Deceived. Temptation is when we are enticed or encouraged to sin. One way or the other. So in Matthew 4, Jesus was led into the desert, what? To be tempted by the devil. He was led into the wilderness. The devil tried to convince Jesus that it would be harmless to jump off a building, and often unmarried people would be so drawn, I'm going to a whole new thing, to sex with their boyfriends or their girlfriends, that they are tempted to do what God says not to do. But what's the word say? So that was Jesus going in the wilderness with the building, you know, jumping off and worship me. And he just used the word. Mm-hmm. And then when he used the word with the devil had to go. Because Jesus said, hey, it is written. God says, it is written. So that's what we should be saying in a temptation. I was just using that as an example because so many people fall into that sin. And we almost think it's okay, it's all right, mm-hmm. because it's just so prevalent on the TV, mm-hmm. and acceptable. You know, it's so acceptable, yeah. It's ridiculous. Yeah. Every TV program you can see a cartoon and they're still doing it.
Yeah.
Like, what the heck?
That's right.
Right in the world. But we as Christians, God tells us it's not of his way, his mm-hmm. righteousness. Mm-hmm. So dealing with temptation, James 4:7, submit yourself there to God. Resist the devil. And he will flee from you. The content of those verses clearly speaking of what? Temptation. Submit yourself to God. Resist the devil and he will flee. Well, you can't resist the devil without the power of God. Some people try to resist the devil, but they don't have no power to resist. Mm-hmm. That's why it says submit. First thing you do is submit to God. You submit. And you know, if you cry out, call out, praise God, worship God, do the weapons of your warfare that are mighty in God, yeah. for the pulling down of the strongholds and temptations, you know, being tempted with your flesh. Mm-hmm. Now God wants you to rise up in the life of the precious spirit so that you can overcome. You have the authority over all the enemy, God says. You've been given the authority. And even the world, the devil and the flesh, all that has no power over the power mm-hmm. of spirit of God that is in it. So we have to tap in, yes. do whatever it takes, mm-hmm. you know, run. And the word of God says, even talking about sexual things, mm-hmm. run, flee, run. Don't try and sit there and resist it. God gave you the word to do it. Mm-hmm. Just run.
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't be saying, well, maybe we're going too far. No, let me stop. Okay, anyway, submit yourself. Okay, the closer you get to God, the more you become aware of his love and the less power temptation has mm-hmm. over you. Mm-hmm. So temptation is very, very strong.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But the bottom line, when you submit You submit, I don't care what it takes, cry out, to call out, to praise, to worship, to get whatever it is, the weapons of your warfare that you're going to start activating so that that spirit of temptation in your flesh, some type of old wretched man that I am, who will deliver me from the body of this death? Is in Christ Jesus. That's who's going to deliver you. Yeah. That's who's already delivered us, because it was nailed to the cross. Yeah. And we have to just remember who we are and whose we are, and that we've been given this authority. We've been given this power over all the enemy. Yeah. And nothing by no means, he said, will hurt us. Yeah. So we have to tap in. Yeah. We have to get in, and then we have to stay in. And it's not impossible, because God is not going to give us any more than we can bear. He's not going to give us orders and instructions in the wisdom of the words of God, because he says you can do all things, right?
That's the thing is, you got to want to. I know when I fell into my temptation, I wanted to.
Right.
So
felt good.
Yeah. And it's like, we can say we can rebuke the devil all we want, but if we put ourselves in those situations, you're going to, like the Bible says, if you play with fire, you cannot take fire into your bosom.
Well, sometimes it's just like I said, deception precedes temptation.
Yeah.
It's not that you can put yourself in it all the time. Sometimes you're placed in it by the deceitful work of the enemy.
Yeah.
So it can be either way.
Yeah.
So whatever it takes to get free from, that's why I say submit to God,
submit to God.
Mm-hmm. Whether you there on your own accord, or rather the enemy tricked you and deceived you into the place where now you're tempted beyond your control. Mm-hmm. Like I said, you can, I don't know why I'm talking about this sex thing all of a sudden, but anyway, you can get a boyfriend that's going to woo you with sweet words. Mm-hmm. It just starts off with just a conversation. Mm-hmm. He's communicating how beautiful and how, you know, you really smell good, you look beautiful, I really, you know, he can even lie and say, I want to marry you, we're going to get to, you know, we're going to, you know, Deception. Mm-hmm. Next thing you know, boom, you're led into that. So if you get up and what? Run! That's what the word says, right?
Yes.
So yeah, so we can fall into it in our own ways, you know, just being disobedient, placing ourselves, because we, you know, a lot of people think because God's grace, oh, he understands, he knows, you know, and God forgives me. Who are you to judge? No, it's the word
that's right.
Judging.
Absolutely.
The word is, you know, searching your heart. Mm-hmm. So with that said, because we are going to discuss temptation, where we may have experienced it and how maybe we've overcome it or maybe fell into it and got back up, I don't know. But the bottom line is temptation is real. And God tells us exactly what to do when we submit. So how do you submit when your flesh is saying, now, do it, or take that another drink, take it now. Oh, you're going to be A-OK, or, you know, whatever it is, or you get offended and you think, oh, I have a right to, they should have never said that, they should have never did that, and God tells us not to be like that. So it's all kinds of ways the enemy tries to trick us and tempt us to fall in sin. So with that said, we're going to take a little break, and we will return. Join us every Tuesday at 5 p.m. for Ladies in Conversation, Spiritually Speaking. We're going to be speaking on different topics because we know that Satan comes to steal, rob, and destroy. And the Word comes to heal, deliver, free, bless, prosper. All these great and awesome, wonderful things that we should be experiencing and we should have now, because we are seated in heavenly places. And when we begin to receive it by faith, and then we know that Satan's what? Satan's best.
Just not good enough.
We're back with you and Ladies in Conversation, and we are talking about temptation. Have you ever fell into temptation after you were born again? Spirit-filled, tongue-talking, Bible-toting, man or woman of God.
Absolutely.
But you fell under, you fell down. But thank God for the name and the life and the blood of Jesus. Thank God that we have an advocate with the Father that we can just say, God, just forgive me. I blew it. I messed up. And then find out how you messed up and how you blew it and how you're not going to let the enemy deceive you, trick you, or even put yourself in that position. Whatever it takes, that the temptation that you're going to be more empowered by it, the fact that it'll never happen. You got me once, but you're mm-hmm. not getting me again. Mm-hmm. You tricked me once. Mm-hmm. You ever hear that little saying? You got me once, yes. you're not doing it again.
You're right.
So with that said, what do you think about temptation? How, I know Beverly was just saying regards to sometimes people put themselves in that position.
Okay. Yeah.
Talk about that.
I know with me, mm-hmm. I had a lot of different areas of temptations, and there's another angle I want to come from. Mm-hmm. But with saying that, the Bible talks about how with the temptation, he makes a way to escape. Mm-hmm. And you have to want to, but if we allow ourselves to get so full into whatever the temptation may be, if you know that you're heading towards a way in an area that you shouldn't, whether it's a place you're going, it's something you're about to say, somebody you're going to be with, whatever the temptation is, we need to make sure, like you said, to run. Mm-hmm. We need to walk and be wise. Now, with me, the temptation that I'm going to come from, because, I mean, I've done...
Well, that's on run with a sexual sin. It specifically says that in the Bible.
Yes.
Not for everything. Yes. Some things, you know.
Yes. So, yes.
Like you got to look for that way of escape.
Yes, you have to look for that way of escape because the Holy Spirit is in us. And he already knew that we were going to be at that situation. Yes. So earlier in during the day, it's like, well, you know, don't do this. Don't go there. Do this. Spend your time in the Word. But when you live in a flesh and blood body, and we always say, oh, God, you understand, I have needs, you know.
Right.
I'm in the prime of my life, or whatever the excuse mm-hmm. may be, comes from a deception.
Sure.
And deception. It's because if I want it, that's it. That my mind is made
right.
up.
Right, yeah, yes. absolutely.
My mind is made
that's
up.
That's it. Ain't nothing going to stop it.
And that's it.
To you what?
Until I
submit
to God. Yes, you have to submit to God, mm-hmm. draw nigh to God, mm-hmm. and then the devil will flee. But we can't always blame it on the devil. Mm-hmm. I can't say, oh, the devil, like Flip Wilson, oh, the devil made me do it. No, I wanted to do it.
Well, it's so in your flesh.
I have to work on my want to. But my area of temptation that really kind of set me back was when I was writing my book. Mm-hmm. And I was so tempted to give up. I read it. I was reading over it. I was working on it. And I said, I don't want to read this. How can I expect anybody else to want to read it? And I had my hand. I was ready to delete the whole thing. I was ready to delete it. And I heard the Spirit of the Lord speak up, and he said, Beverly. He said, I am not going to write this book for you. I'm going to write it through you. So have fun. So I wrote that on the top of my manuscript. And the reason why I'm bringing this up is because a lot of times we think about temptation as being the obvious sin, you know, going here, taste not, don't do this. But the temptation to thwart the plans of God and walk away because we don't feel good enough to do it mm-hmm. goes back to the deception. Yes. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times we run across people who are church hurt. They're tempted to leave the church. They're tempted to do this. They're tempted to... basically call God a liar. That's just as much as a sin, is when you walk away from the plans and purposes of God. And I almost did that. I came this close to doing that. Now, with the other sins and the other things that I fell in, it's like, okay, I was able to see where I made my mistake. I can see where I allowed myself to be lured or said or somebody pulled me into because they said something and I may have retaliated or whatever the situation may have been, I could clearly see that. But the underlying current of that sin and temptation of not to go and push yourself forward to do what God has for me to do, because what he has for me to do and what he has for you to do and what he has for you to do, somebody needs that.
Right.
The sexual sins is the sin against the body. You're sinning against your body. Yes, you're hurting yourself, you're condemning yourself, you're hurting another person. But when you're so tempted to not feel like you're worthy to do what God has for you to do, you're hurting your community.
And I think... But you've become the gift that God wants you to be.
And
the enemy is trying to abort the plan and purpose.
That was one of the things the Lord showed me was a big temptation of mine because of that lie that I believed growing up.
Well, again, it comes right down to the plan and the purpose that God has for your life, that you won't fulfill the potential of who God called you to be to your generation, to the world, whatever. So you can be tempted in all kinds of ways.
Yeah, absolutely.
But one of the things we're looking at right now is the tactics of the enemy, how he uses the accusing, temptations, mm-hmm. and deception, mm-hmm. how he does it to bring that believer mm-hmm. into a place of not receiving all God has purpose mm-hmm. for them,
right.
whether it's on their own volition or whether it's through how the enemy deceives you. And but again, there's always an answer. Bottom line, you submit to God, resist the devil, mm-hmm. and he must go. Mm-hmm. You have been given the authority over all the enemy, mm-hmm. and nothing by no means will hurt you.
Mm-hmm.
Where you are weak, I am your strength.
Mm-hmm.
And when he's tempting, there's, again, God gives us a way of escape. Mm-hmm. So there's all kinds of word mm-hmm. that God gives mm-hmm. us, whether it's on our own volition again, whether it's deceived into it,
mm-hmm.
whether it's a gross sin, whether it's a small sin,
mm-hmm.
whether it's something we not even consider a sin until the Lord starts mm-hmm. Convicting us
mm-hmm.
or correcting us mm-hmm. or rebuking us.
Mm-hmm.
So with that said, Sonia, give us your take on temptation.
Okay. Well, just like Beverly, in regards to what we believe and mm-hmm. how we're deceived and how we view ourselves,
mm-hmm.
it's like the identity,
mm-hmm.
you know, mistaken identity, put it that way.
Right.
And so because I was dealing with the rejection and all those things like that, as we mentioned last week, that caused me to fall into a lot of sexual sin,
mm-hmm.
a lot of falling into mm-hmm. getting into adulterous relationships and just repeated.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that once I was born again and, you know, on fire for God, that I wouldn't fall again.
Mm-hmm.
But then I found myself there again.
Mm-hmm.
So believing someone mm-hmm. that you said, you know, the divorce is here, you know, just basically lied to me
mm-hmm.
about him. And his wife being divorced
mm-hmm.
and stuff. So I believe in that. But there was something in me after a while. It's like, well, I need to see the divorce papers,
mm-hmm.
you know, but I was already in it.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I was already mm-hmm. in it. He was like nice to me, saying all the nice things,
mm-hmm.
taking care of me and my kids, you
mm-hmm.
know, just speaking life into me, all the things that I needed,
yeah.
that I was looking for in
yeah.
a man
yeah.
versus relying on what God was saying, because
mm-hmm.
he wasn't saying anything better than what God was already telling me,
right.
you know. But I fell into that,
mm-hmm.
and I really had to look at myself, and it had to take me to fall so hard
mm-hmm.
and to feel so much shame and stuff. And I still dealt with that even
mm-hmm.
after. I had to like get myself, separate myself, go and speak with God, like, what is this?
Right.
I found out it was generational.
Right.
Mm. My father, you know, was in a lot of adulterous relationships.
Mm.
And so it was that generational curse, and I didn't know how to break it.
Right.
I didn't know why I was doing that. And it was that searching for that love in all the wrong places.
Mm.
And it just boiled down to the point of I didn't value myself.
Mm. So when you asked the Lord, which was great, because that was your first sign of, this is the issue. This is the problem.
Yeah.
You submit it to God.
Yeah, amen.
You submit it to God.
Yeah.
It was just a question.
Mm-hmm.
You could submit however, you know, you have to do the submission to him. He's going to give you that way of escape. He's going
mm-hmm.
to give you the wisdom. He's going to give you the direction. He's going to give you the instructions, because sometimes we don't even have enough faith.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's a very
yes.
important thing. We can't see it the way God sees it.
Mm-hmm.
We can't even feel it the way he wants us to experience his life, his power, his authority, his presence. So the enemy is constantly after, because we're still in this earthen vessel learning spiritual things. So it's just like a 5-year-old and a 15-year-old. Your 5-year-old is going to do totally different than your 15-year-old you would expect. It's a 15
yeah,
or 16-year-old
yeah.
with, you know,
yeah.
as far as their obedience to you and what they learn, what they know.
Right.
So a lot of times, God's not going to judge us on, you know, a lot of things that we maybe even judge ourselves,
mm-hmm.
because he already knows what we know, what
mm-hmm.
we don't know,
mm-hmm.
and what he has to guide and lead
mm-hmm.
us and instruct us and show us the way in how to, you know, when we get into these ditches, God is the one that rescues us and gets
yeah.
us out of them,
mm-hmm. yeah.
you know.
Mm-hmm.
So even if we miss the mark, which we're going to miss the mark as long as you're on this earth,
mm-hmm.
we're going to miss it, whether you miss the way of escape, whether you miss submitting to God first, and whether
yeah.
you resist knowing that you have more power than the enemy
yeah.
in Christ Jesus,
yeah.
not in your own
yeah.
attitude
yeah.
or thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess my temptation, dealing with the temptation, was just was something that when the enemy, it goes right back to what you were basically saying, how you think you can't do this, and you're not good enough, or you're not smart enough, or you're not this enough, you're not that enough. Mm-hmm. And so you just kind of don't do anything.
Right.
You know, you back up, back off, and just, you know, go through the rituals. Because I was, it's so many ways to be tempted. You know, like you were saying, and you were saying as well, that it can be self-induced, an enemy deceiving you and tricking you into it. So, like I said, there were just so many ways that the enemy tried to tempt me to just sometimes, you know, why can't I just be a normal Christian? Why I gotta do all this? I mean, I can just die and go to heaven, you know? Just, you know, what is this? You know, you see people, you know, they still do whatever, but there's almost like a stronger conviction, you know?
Right. Oh,
yeah. And that you have to kind of participate in and live up to, because now you're held accountable and responsible. Mm-hmm. So you can't be falling in to the certain things that other people right. seem to fall into, and they still praising the Lord and having a great time. Yeah. And I said, wait a minute, hold it.
Can I much give it to
why? Well, that's true. Yeah. So I said, well, can I just go to church on Sunday and, you know, read my word and be a nice little Christian? Be all sweet and kind. But anyway, you know, that, and it's all kinds of ways the enemy, like you said, you know, can tempt us, or just a deception or self-induced, whatever it may be. Mm-hmm. But we have to grow in faith.
Absolutely.
We have to grow in faith, mm-hmm. and we have to submit to God, submit mm-hmm. to God, submit to God. Because He got all kinds of ways to instruct us, like He instructed you and told you, you know, why you was experiencing what you were experiencing. No man, mere man told you that. Mm-hmm. That was the Spirit of God ministering to you. Mm-hmm. And when you was getting ready to hit that delete,
yes.
and it was God, yes. because Beverly was like, hey, I'm done with this.
Yes.
Boom! But God's family, yes. He interrupted you right then and there. Yes. And you know it was God, because it wasn't your thought.
No.
Right. Wasn't your thought at all. No. You weren't even thinking like that. No. You was thinking.
Yes, I was.
He was about to go down.
I was. Yes.
But God, see, because you're right, because the enemy was trying to stop the blessing, stop the gift, stop the word in that book to bless people, to liberate people, to deliver and mm-hmm. to bring people into a understanding of why they feel maybe the way they feel, mm-hmm. because somebody got allowed to go through that mm-hmm. and brought them out of that, over that, and now they're up to be able to tell it. Mm-hmm. And the enemy's, oh no, we can't have this book. Yep. Yeah, that was, you know, just not a godly thought.
Yeah.
And again, you know, going back to, you know, Sonia and what God spoke to her. So God is never, ever, you know, once you, you know, you even if you're about to go off the blink, or you're about to jump the cliff, you know, God, His commitment to us is to rescue us, to save us. When you say, Jesus, come into my heart and be Lord and Savior of my life, that's saving you. Yes. That's a part of being saved. That's a part of being rescued from the powers of the enemy and his deceitful works of darkness. That's the way that God will operate, even when we don't have the faith to know, or the wisdom to know, or the knowledge to know. My people are perishing for lack of knowledge. God will send, and I say it all the time, He'll send somebody from Timbuktu just to get to you. Because He has a plan. He has a plan that's already mapped out, purpose, strategized for your life to bring glory, honor, and praise to holy one name, and that's His name. And we have to be wanting and willing, surrendering and yielding to say, God, I don't may understand it all. I don't know how you're going to do it, the way you're going to do it, but faith stands in its place. Faith says, God, you have your way. Faith says, I know that your plans is to do me good and not to do me harm, and to give me hope and an expected end. So when the enemy's trying to torment you, lie to you, trick you, bring guilt and condemnation on you, you have to do whatever as you submit to God, then He'll get to tell you which way to go. And even if you don't submit, just at least look for that way of escape. At least stop and listen to the inner voice. There's something God's trying to get to you. So with that said, we're going to give God the glory and the honor and the praise, and thank God that we're going to continuously overcome the temptations. As long as we're on this earth, we will be tempted by the world, the devil, and the flesh. But thank God for the power of the blood. Thank God for the greater one that's in us. Thank God that we will submit, that we will surrender, that we will trust, and that we will obey, and that God will make a way out of no way. God bless you, and we will see you next week.